Welcome to Getting Started with FME Server. Some of you are already familiar with FME Desktop, where you can connect to data in a multitude of formats and systems and author a wide variety of data transformations. So, we say that the power of FME Desktop is in the transformation. With FME Server, we say that the power is in the automation. This means that you can take any transformation or workspace that is created with FME Desktop and run it in a wide variety of ways using FME Server. In this four-part tutorial, we will cover some basics of FME Server. We will take a tour of the FME Server web user interface. We will run a sample workspace from the FME Server web interface. We will publish our own workspace from FME Desktop to FME Server and download data. We will modify our workspace so users can customize their data download. And finally, we will set up a schedule for when our workspace will run. Let's get started with FME Server. If you would like to follow along with your own FME Server, there are three prerequisites. First, FME Server must be installed and licensed. You must add sample workspaces and enable installed services. We will start by taking a quick tour of the FME Server web interface. You can open the web user interface in a couple of different ways. Type in your hostname /FME Server as the URL in a browser window. The host name was specified during the installation. Or you may also access it from the Windows Start menu. You can find FME Server in the Programs list and click on Web User Interface. For the purpose of this tutorial, we can log in with the default author username and author password that gets set up with the installation. The three large buttons represent the most common tasks carried out with FME Server: Run Workspace, Manage Schedules, and Manage Notifications. Beneath this are links to favorite workspaces, last published, and last run workspaces. These are all empty right now because this is a fresh installation. Towards the bottom are links to upcoming webinars, blogs, and training. The bottom left is where you will find information about the build and version of your FME Server. Scroll to the top and check out the menu options. Home will always bring you back to this page. Run takes you to the Run Workspace page, which is the same page that the Run Workspace button takes you to. Under Manage are a number of options for configuring FME Server. You may see the Help menu for links to documentation and articles, including resources for developers. And finally, we have the User Session menu. Run one of the sample workspaces from the web user interface. Click on the Run Workspace button. This is where we can select and run a workspace that has already been published to FME Server. Choose the repository that the workspace is in. You can think of a repository as a folder in which to store related items. Currently, there is just a samples repository, so go ahead and select it. Choose which workspace to run. The workspace dropdown lists the workspaces within the samples repository. Select austinapartments.fmw. Select the service with which to run the workspace. This one was registered with 4 services. We will discuss services some more when we publish and register our own workspace. For now, select the data streaming service. Click on Run Workspace. The workspace is executed in FME, and the result, in this case a KMZ file, is downloaded.